Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good morning everyone. I'm Akbar Dwi Prasetyo. Here I want to make a presentation about Chris Siminfeng. Who is Chris Siminfeng? Chris Siminfeng is you can call her Chris Feng. He is a Singapore entrepreneur and the CEO of marketplace application Shopee. Chris Feng born on 4 December 1982. Chris Feng studied at the National University of Singapore and majored in computer science. They received a college scholarship from the Singapore government and got the best graduate. After that, he continued at America in Stanford University in the field of management science and engineering. Okay, next. Chris Feng is known to have worked for a long time at the management consulting company McKinsey and in Frankfurt, Germany. At that place of work, Chris Feng spent 7 years, and after leaving McKinsey, he then moved to work at Rocket Internet. There, Chris Feng managing direction of Zalora and for the South Asia region. Apart from that, Chris Feng also served as chief processing officer at Lazada South Asia, and he held the position for approximately 3 years. And after that, he then joined Akarana, which is underlined office of Forest Lee CL Limited. It was his Chris Feng finally took the position on CEO of mobile business at Karana. After 1 year in the position head of mobile business at Karana, Chris Feng and Forest Lee decided to marketplace scale Shopee in 2015. Chris Feng also later served as CEO of Shopee, and the marketplace he created was first and launching in Singapore. Shopee is also under the office of the CLTD. Okay, about what is Shopee? Shopee is a online market application shop. We can more easily shop, explore, and sell any product and serve anywhere. Shopee can help seller more easily offer their merchandise and assist buyer in making transaction in interesting directly with seller through its live chat feature. The first time Shopee was launched in 2005 in Singapore. Since then, Shopee has begun expand in reach to Thailand, Indonesia, Malaysia, Vietnam, Philippines, and Taiwan. Shopee itself was founded under the office of the CL Limited, and Shopee have the concept of C2C market, or customer to customer, and C change to a hybrid C2C, or customer to customer, and B2C is business to customer. This has been going on since the launch Shopee Mall, which is include the Shopee online shop, platform distribute product from well-known brands. Next, about the difficulties situation Chris Feng in Shopee. In the middle of 2023, Shopee has experienced loss and had loss for the hundreds of employees. According to the Business Times, she limited for Rasley and passed that there were will be a projective profits the company will achieve in an email to employees on December 22, 2023. And Shopee parent company CLDD, which is listed on the New York Stock Exchange, actually recorded a profit in the first semester of 23, but the C performance reversed to a net loss of around 1,014 US dollar million in 1,000 US million in the third quarter of 2023. Furthermore, in November 2023, management began to narrow in investment strategy and began to record profits gain. Meanwhile, previously during a period loss, Shopee decided to lay off employment to invest efficiently. It is known that Shopee has let the employers, it is around 200 people, mostly in the customer service division. In 2022, Shopee has also cut around 7 jobs since June 2022. Of around 10%, it is total employees, and it is struggle to reduce mounting loss. This is wave of layoff from online retailers. It is now to have seen Shopee lose almost 19% of its market capitalization since its peak position last year due to question about its prospect for making money in an area rising interesting and increasingly fierce competition. However, after paying to disagreement to ability generate significant profit from the company business in the first semester of 2023, she shifted to acceleration growth rather than the maximum profit in the last few months. Meanwhile, in the main focus in the significant investment made PC includes the acquisition of user and influencer for its live streaming e-commerce strategy, as well expanding Shopee subsidies. Based on limited data, Shopee still occupies the first position in e-commerce within the highest number of visitors during May 2023 with 161 million visitors. Shopee visitor number surpassed Tokopedia 106 million visitor and Lazada 7 million visitor. Fading from data AR also shown that Shopee is the number one online shop platform in Indonesia with the high total number of download throughout 2022. Both on Google Play and the Play Store, Shopee is also the number one online shopping platform with the highest number of monthly active user. Based on a Bookilab survey, Shopee has rated as the number one e-commerce platform in Indonesia. This is because Shopee is the e-commerce platform that it is best now considered 73% and usage 63%. E-commerce of most consumer 65%, especially women. Poylabs also created that Shopee can occupy this top ranking because of three things. First, promotion. Shopee is a subsidiary of the C Groups, which is founded by investor from Tencent. Thanks for investor funds, Shopee can issue various types on promotion. Apart from the big promotion, Shopee also pay attention to their visiting collaboration with the figure who as who as associate with lower middle class. He is shown that Shopee looks more familiar. Second, that games feature on Shopee is designed to increase customer engagement, shown that customer remain in the Shopee application. Third, Shopee provide various features to make easier for customer to pay, e-wallet features such as Shopee Pay and money lending service such as Shopee Pay Later and Shopee Pay Pinjam increase consumer purchasing power. Thank you for attending, guys, and see you for next time. Bye bye.